What's up, Damien?
I'm just using the Torrent Onion router.
What's that?
Oh, well, the Tor browser is the most private and safest internet browser in the whole world.
Why don't you just use Google?
Well, because on Google, advertisers can sell my information, and the government's watching me 24/7. On Tor, I have the luxury of privacy.
Hey Sam, so how do I get it? Just search up Tor and then download it. It's that easy.
Really? Okay, I'm gonna go do that right now.
Every single time you surf the web, you are under threat of being watched, having your identity stolen for as little as 40 cents. The Onion Router is a web browser that lets you explore the internet freely and safely. The Tor project began in the early 2000s, created by a couple of MIT graduates. In 2008, the Tor browser was created, making the Onion Router free and accessible to everyday internet users. This browser has continued to grow in popularity ever since.
Companies like Google, Facebook, Apple, Microsoft, they all get together with the NSA and provide the NSA direct access to the back ends of all of the systems you use to communicate.
Snowden, the man himself, the person who told the world that the CIA and FBI were robbing us of our privacy and telling us the truth about what's really happening in the government. Mass surveillance. What is it? It's tapping every single phone, camera, or any kind of recording device and electronic to see what you're doing in your everyday life. Snowden was the person to tell the population that this is happening. Without him, we wouldn't know that the government is watching us 24/7.
They're going to say I've committed grave crimes, I've, you know, violated the Espionage Act. They're going to say, you know, I've aided our enemies.
It's the first Arab revolution of the 21st century, or it will be brutally suppressed.
Spring. During 2010-2011, there were many uprisings in the Middle East and North Africa. The countries Tunisia, Syria, Egypt, Iraq, Libya, Bahrain, and Yemen had tens of thousands of peaceful protesters striving for more democratic politics and civil rights. During these protests, there were many military suppression of the civilians, and through that, they gained popularity and power through social media and uncensored networking through Tor. Due to this power of the people, they made many presidents of these countries step down after decades of autocratic ruling, giving fair rights to them and the children of the future.
Firewalls. A firewall is a system designed to prevent access to or from a private network. The internet was created to be a utopia where anyone, anytime, anywhere can access, but the government feels that they have the right to take some of that freedom and put firewalls over it. Some countries have big firewalls, but there are six individual countries that are very stern on their internet access. There is China, Turkey, United Arab Emirates, Iran, Egypt, and Vietnam. China has the biggest firewall issue. Citizens can only access government-run sites on their internet. Activist events such as Tiananmen Square are strictly forbidden from the internet and is known to be punishable by death. The internet is internationally censored. Most people are only accessing 6% of the whole internet. In fact, 94% of the internet is in the deep web.
They took it off Netflix.
It is on Netflix. I'm watching it on Tor.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, like you said, I downloaded it yesterday. I researched a bunch of ones on it. And I went on the Pirate Bay. There was like millions of movies, videos. Really wanting to watch Wall Street, so I'm watching it.
Really? It's awesome. I'll check it out.
Sure.
Alright, see you later.
I'll see you later.
We created a local server to see what people thought of Tor. And, of course, the answer is not surprising.
Have you heard of Tor/the deep web?
No, I have not ever.
No.
Pretty much nothing. I just heard that's kind of sketchy.
I know, it's really scary.
Not really. I've heard of it.
You've heard of it?
Yeah.
Good things or bad things?
Mostly bad.
I know a couple of my friends use it, but that's it.
Like a black hole.
Just that it's a place where people go online where they do things they don't want people to know that they're involved in.
You can only access it with specific links to things.
and there's a lot of like illegal activity.
I heard that there's like human trafficking involved in it.
Not much. I think they sell organs.
Can't you buy organs off the deep
web? I know that you can buy like drugs and liquor and alcohol and guns.
You buy illegal stuff, such as children, drugs, anything like that.
It's like an underground thing that where people, buy illegal things or transport things without being like caught. So they use cryptocurrency.
It's got child trafficking on it. I know there used to be a massive circle on the deep web called the Silk Road that got shut down earlier. And the deep web used to be protected by Tor, which was like a way the internet would like route so the government couldn't track you.
There is this massive stigma around Tor and the deep web, where it is strictly illegal markets and illegal activity. And yes, there is a vast majority of the economy within the deep web, which is illegal markets, which gives the opportunity to people to have that freedom to do illegal activity. Though there is a lot of activism, people in with communities sharing information and whistleblowing illegal activity happening in the surface world, where people would have their lives destroyed if they weren't anonymous. This should not be underestimated. As I was saying before, it may change in the world, massive change. And it is a freedom to all people to have this available.
Tor is not just a software. It is a community of people. Tor is a tool. Tor is an educator. Tor is a browser. One striving towards privacy and true freedom for all.
Every way like MJ. I can't believe today was a good